Yes, friends, are you getting my voice? It's raining here. So due to that, some disturbance happened. Okay, come to the point, ma.
That's all. What I am seeing?
Yes, my corporates offer the acidic nature present in the stomach. Acidic nature. And also reduces too much acidity. Next, mucus. The mucus protects inner lining of the stomach from highly concentrated HCl. Okay, when our stomach is empty, at that moment, HCl will damage the inner lining of our stomach. In such cases, this mucus will protect our inner epithelial lining from damaging, from HCl damaging. Okay, so the HCl will damage our inner lining when the stomach is empty. In such cases, the mucus will protect our inner lining of the stomach from damaging by the HCl. That's why whenever we should not keep our stomach empty. If the food is not available, from banana you take and two biscuits, you eat and drink water. Then HCl will act on food material. It does not cause any harmful effects to inner lining of the stomach. Or otherwise, it damages our inner lining of the stomach. Then we will face acidity. In future, whatever we eat, so after eating that in esophagus, something burning sensation we will get. Severe burning sensation we will get. Okay? That's why whenever we should not keep our stomach empty. Our stomach is empty. If we keep our stomach is empty, so the HCl will damage our inner lining of the stomach. So this is the explanation about digestion in the stomach. It carries 5 marks question. In annual exam, describe briefly about the physiology of digestion in stomach. You would have to represent these all the points. Digestion in small intestine. Okay, see here diagram. So everybody knows that here up to now the digestion takes place in the stomach. That's what we have seen. After that, the food is okay. So partially digested food is entered into the small intestine through pyloric sphincter. Okay, that's here. Pyloric sphincter. Okay, pyloric aperture is guarded by the pyloric sphincter. That's something we have discussed. Okay, so through those pyloric aperture, the chyme is entered into the small intestine where the complete digestion takes place. Okay, next, various movements. feelings are generated by muscularis externa. Yes, ma. Network issue is rising. Now outside raining, environment suddenly changed. So some of the places commonly network issue comes. We cannot do anything. No problem. I am sending video. Okay. So recorded video I will send it. Okay. Various movements are generated by muscularis externa. Various movements are generated by muscularis externa layer of small intestine. Small intestine. Even in small intestine also various muscles are not present. So those muscles will show various kinds of movements. Okay, that is only various movements generated by muscularis externa layer of the small intestine, which helps in thorough mixing of the food material. So these movements helps in thorough mixing up of the food with bile, pancreatic juice, enteric acid is intestinal juice. See, from the liver, bile is entered. From the pancreas, pancreatic juice is entered. These all entered into the small intestine. Clear? Bile from the liver, pancreatic juice from the pancreas, intestinal juice, succus entericus from the intestine. All are mixing up thoroughly with the food, and thereby facilitation. Okay. All materials are thoroughly with the food, the process of digestion is complete. Okay, so here if small intestine has mucus and bicarbonates. Mucus and bicarbonates helps in protecting the inner lining of the small intestine and provide alkaline medium and reduces acidity. Okay, that's all. Mucus and bicarbonates both protects inner lining small intestine and prevent the acidity and provides the alkaline medium. So the alkaline medium is very suitable for enzymatic action. Okay, in acidic medium cannot perform very effectively. That's why acidic medium is gradually turned to be reduces acidic medium and provides alkaline medium. The alkaline medium is suitable for enzymatic action. Okay, that is one thing. Next, proximal cells of duodenum. See, this is duodenum, anterior, medial, middle, posterior. The duodenum also three parts: anterior, middle, posterior. Anterior, proximal. The proximal cells of the duodenum called duodenum. This is called duodenum. Proximal means these anterior cells. The proximal cells of the duodenum secretes large amount of bicarbonate. Large amounts of bicarbonates. Proximal cells of the duodenum secretes large amounts of bicarbonates. This bicarbonate neutralizes gastric juice that enter into the small intestine. So from the, some of the gastric juice enter into the small intestine. The total gastric juice entered into the small intestine, neutralized by the proximal cells of the duodenum, secretes excess amount of bicarbonates, which neutralizes the gastric juice that is entered into the small intestine. Okay, here bile juice from the liver, pancreatic juice from the pancreas, intestinal juice from the small intestine, all are work very effectively in alkaline medium. Alkaline medium works very effectively in alkaline medium. Okay, so this is the explanation, digestion in small intestine. So for the fermentation, so still more proteins, proteases, peptones, fats, carbohydrates, nucleic acids, how those will be digested, that is what we will see in next class. But today I will stop the class because outside is continuously raining, so I am getting signal, even network is not up to the mark, like that showing on screen. So for today I am stopping the class. Today my class meeting session is finished, so this recorded video I will upload in WhatsApp group. Have a look on that. So some students sent some doubts, so let me have a look on those. Jyoti Pujari, sorry, Sezal, yes sir, okay, yes sir, network issue, yes ma'am. So network issue, we cannot do that. So further continuation we will have a look on next class. For today class is finished, so get ready for lunch.